Hello everyone and welcome back to another session of Dark Souls 3 Focused PvP. Today is an episode of our One Souls because these weapons don't have our two attacks. We're using the Cleric's Candlestick and the Golden Ritual Spear. I can do jump attacks, so we do have that going for us. Woo. Defensive. Woo. Fun. I can walk in circles at a distance away from you as well. Oh yes, fear my damage output. Yeah, that beautiful 120 damage per hit. Shocking, we lost. Never would have guessed that. So yeah, these weapons kind of suck. Like, a lot. So never mind the fact that I've got around 300 some odd attack rating, close to 400 with it. You shouldn't expect anything over 175 damage on the regular. And bear in mind, this is with my... This one's 362, to be fair. But, yeah, it's just bad. It's just not a good weapon. Straight sword move to is all well and good, but... It's just a bad weapon. So expect basically a montage of losses throughout this video. That's the way it's gonna go. Can't cast with them because I don't have the proper stats for that because I couldn't manage to get the proper stats. And I barely have any spells to cast anyway, so it's not like it really would have mattered. So, there's that. Overall, it's just a bad time. This weapon leaves a lot to be desired. Its attack rating is kind of garbage. Its moveset is okay, but you don't have any actual R2s because it's meant to cast. And... You know, it's a straight sword moveset, but the R2s, I miss them. I miss my R2s. Damage output is the biggest problem, though, of course, because it's just bad. Didn't I just fight you? Deja vu much. Yay, backpedaling. Wonderful. Wonderful bit of damage right there, guys. No. What's this? Candlestick? Shockingly, we lost again. Whoa! Defensive katanas. Oh no. Yeah. Oh yeah, that's the way this is gonna be. There's a reason why I saved these things for last, and that's because they royally suck. The levels of suck are high. Not only do they suck, but I suck too because I can't use them as good as some other people. Shame about that. But you know, there's a reason why these things aren't even close to being common. I mean, let's be honest now. Requiring faith but scaling off of intelligence, that's a little bit odd. And then requiring intelligence and scaling off of faith, again, a little bit odd. This one's spell buff isn't bad though. It's got that going for it. Now there is a shield. I don't think I've ever seen anyone use it. Hyperword armored through that. That was odd. We turned it around well enough for, you know, only being able to do R1s. I would have loved to have R2s on this thing. I would have loved to have more spells and miracles and all that to cast, but I don't have anything. And you know, for when we get to the point in the video where we actually would normally use both, we're not gonna use both. It's not gonna help out enough. We're gonna just do them individually and end it there. That's good enough for me, because I can only stand using these things for so long. I can only be sane with it for so long. It is what it is. And it is, in fact, bad. I mean, when I do better with the broken straight sword than I do with this, that's kind of a problem. Just a little bit. Just a wee bit.
Hey!
Alright, friend. What do you have? Flamberge. Okay. You. Too much R1. R1ing is my job, friend. Okay, 3 hits done that time. That's totally cool, I suppose. But that shouldn't have been a thing. Never mind that it was, again, for like the millionth time. It shouldn't have been. Shame too, because I was doing really good that fight. We might have actually won had that 3 hits done not happened. Hooray for inconsistencies. Gotta love it, guys. I know I'm loving it. Not sponsored. Wouldn't want to be sponsored by McDonald's anyway. Haven't had McDonald's in a long time. Long, long time. It's been since before I moved out here, actually. Been over a little over a year, I think, since I've last had McDonald's. That's a good problem. Those are good problems. Those are good things to have going on in my life. Cut out McDonald's, cut out Taco Bell. Pretty much cut out all fast food, for the most part. I am a sucker for Steak and Shake, though, I'll admit that. And Five Guys. Because sometimes, you know, I'm just too lazy to make myself a burger. I tried to jump attack and I started looking at my sword instead. Yeah, about that. I also love the fact that people feel it's necessary to buff up when they even see me using this thing. I mean, really? Really, really? Don't you guys know how bad this weapon is? But so far, so good on my prediction of it being a death montage. We've got that going for us. It means that so far I'm right, and I do enjoy being right. I do admit that, freely. I like to be right. Not that I'm intentionally dying for the sake of being right, of course, but, you know. When you accidentally look at your weapon instead of doing a jump attack, that causes problems. But now we've got this, which is going to be okay-ish. It's a spear moveset, kinda. It's something, to say the least. It's something. Oh, it's you again. Nice little combo. I'm surprised that actually worked, but that's fine. Okay, hello, failure at timing everything in the world. Pokey pokey. Oh, we got a parry! That's actually not bad damage on the parry. Not bad damage on the riposte at all. That's a surprise. Can I turtle poke with this? I can. It's a bad plan because it will get me in trouble. I know that. No! My running attack was almost there. And we're still good on the prediction. We've got that going for us. It's going strong. Oh man, this is rough, guys. This is just rough. So close, though. So close. Almost had it. That actually was surprisingly decent damage on the riposte, though. So, that's a good thing, actually. So, you know, I'm okay with that. That's fine by me. Not gonna lie, though, I'm actually just looking forward to being done recording. Trying to get the respect for this, I had to actually invade. Ew. First off, just ew. I used to love invading, but in this game, it's just so bad, and the ganks are just so bad. There's a set of guys ganking here who... That's stupid. Because 4v1s and all that are always fun. Really, Onikiri Nubadachi against this, and you feel the need to... Really? Wait, huh? What? Okay, first off, you feel the need to buff against this, that's kind of sad. Second, that L1 spam, that's also stupid. And third, how the hell did that backstab happen? That makes no sense. But we're still good on the prediction. But yeah, you know, invading here sucks. Invading in this game sucks. But there's the set of guys ganking, and that's normal, whatever. 4v1s are 4v1s, they're always fun. Or something like that. And then, when I did finally stop running into them, I invaded another guy, who had two Aldrich Faithful in the world. So I was like, okay, I'll let them do their thing. I sat down and waited. And while they were fighting, they fought him one at a time. And then a blue came in, and I was fighting the blue, and the blue ran away. Okay, I'll walk forward instead. The blue ran away, and... nice, parry. Ran behind the host. Then the host acted like he wanted to fight me. So I was like, okay, whatever, I'll fight the host. I healed up, everything was fine. And... am I actually gonna win this? Oh my god, I won a fight, my prediction was wrong! I've never been so happy to be wrong. Oh, it's that guy I was fighting the other fight, other video back. So yeah. The blue went and hid behind the host, healed up, whatever. And everything was peachy. And then I started fighting the host, and we were doing fine. The other Aldrich Faithful was just sitting there. And then suddenly, the Aldrich Faithful and the blue casted at me at the exact same time. And I died. Like, instantly, of course. Because, you know, two Crystal Soul Spears coming at you at once will do that. But, like, really? You guys were fighting him one-on-one, I was fighting him one-on-one, and you didn't like something about that? Don't get so cocky with your L1's friend. Shame on that. Again, all things considered though, for the weapons I'm using, I did pretty decently against that. For what I have, I can't complain. If I were not using weapons that had split damage, if I were using something on a quality build, I probably would have won instead. And if he hadn't caught me on the side with his L2 as well, that might have gone slightly different, because that catch let him get an L1 on me. A mage, and he's wearing the bunny ears, so that very well means that he will take a bit extra damage to me. Oh, hello, lag. That was a bit funky of a running attack. Is the magic gonna start coming? Okay, I guess I just won't roll. That's fair too. I'll just run straight into his cast instead of, you know, rolling when I press it. Fine. Perfectly fine. Still right though, by the way. Well, almost right. We did have one win, but that doesn't... that was... you know, it is what it is. Either way, though, I'm done. I can't stand using these things any longer. I'm good. Promise. I'm not dying. Only a little. But I'm fine. I will live. Either way, though, guys, we only have a couple of weapons left to use. We only have the Morn's Great Hammer and the Saint Bident. Is that right? Oh, and the Scholar's Candlestick. So that's all we've got left. So I'll probably use the Scholar's and the Saint Bident next time. Respec one final time for Morn's, and then that'll be it. Simple as that. We'll be done. So two more videos. Kind of crazy, right? Every single weapon in the game, done. A little bit odd, a little bit crazy that it's done so quickly. Either way, we're almost there. We're in the home run. We're in the home run. We're in the home stretch. That's the term. I can't English. Don't worry about it. I'm fine. Either way, I'm done for this video. I hope you all enjoyed this little losing streak with that one win dead in the middle. Dead set in the middle. You mean what I know. Either way, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all next time.